walking along Charlestown, wishing you were Banner Strand, holding your nephew's hands. We walked along the waterfront, up Bunker, down on Main. We met at the monument, where everyone knew our names. Our first kiss on 40 flights, our friends on the stoop on summer nights. The church door was always open as the bells rang out for you and me, for all to see on our wedding.
Good evening and welcome to Charlestown Live. I'm Kathy Giordano. I'm one of your hosts tonight. Welcome to the show. Before we get started, let me thank our partner, Charlestown Against Drugs, and our sponsors, Partners Healthcare, which includes MGH Charlestown, MGH Institute of Health Professionals, MGH at the Charlestown Navy Yard, the Spalding Rehab Hospital, and the MGH SHOP program. Without their help, we couldn't bring this show to you. So I'm going to move right along because we have a lot to talk about, and we have an extremely special, I always say we have a special guest, but tonight, I mean it, really, I meant it all the other time. I'm getting myself in a lot of trouble. So I'm going to bring in here a guy that usually gets me in trouble, my co-host, Billy Boyle. Hi, Bill.
Good evening, welcome. It's great to be on, especially with the guy we get on tonight. We're sort of looking forward to it. This is a fill-in night for us, but we couldn't think of a better guy to fill in. And without any ado, I think we should get into the program because mm-hmm. we got a lot to talk about. So with that, I'll turn it back over to Cookie.
Okay, there's been a big, big announcement in Charlestown this week. And that announcement is that our representative, Gene O'Flaherty, is leaving his position as our state representative and taking a position under the new Mayor Marty Walsh Administration. So with that, welcome, Gene. We're glad you're here to talk about this tonight.
Well, it's great to be here. And as always, I want to say thank you, Cookie, and thank you, Billy, for what you do here on Charlestown Live. You know, over the years, this show has brought to the folks in Charlestown all the goings-on in the community, mm-hmm. and it's important what you do here, and you provide a great public service. So I want to thank all of you for doing that. And yes, I did make an announcement, and the announcement is certainly bittersweet. I want you to know that being your representative is the best privilege that I have been given in my life. It is something that I will always hold dear to me, something that I will always remember fondly, and will always consider the people of Charlestown and Chelsea as my constituents, no matter where I go in life.
And we'll never forget you and your service to
our community.
Well,
thank you. I appreciate that. And I did make the announcement, and my family and I came to the decision. Certainly, politics is a business where when you enter it, you always aspire for the best that you can do. And certainly, over the years, I have tried to do the best that I can, being the representative and representing the neighborhood. And certainly was put in a position up on Beacon Hill that is one that I'm very proud of in terms of the record and what we've been able to do for the district. Oftentimes, folks back home may just see what you do in terms of your district, showing up at a local event or presenting a citation or announcing a grant award. But oftentimes, the public is unaware of what takes place in our building. And my staff, which has some great Charlestown folks
mm-hmm. yes,
on it, Alexis and Sean and many other people that have had contact with our office always comment on our staff and how well mm-hmm. that they've treated the district over the years, and I'm very privileged to have worked with them. Honored to call them all friends, and we're all part of a big happy family, and we'll stay that way over the years. But I think that when you think about the building, oftentimes the people back home don't understand what it takes to be a representative, but also to go into that building and work with 159 other people. Mm. Oftentimes there's an expectation that you can do things overnight, but it's a process that requires patience. It requires, in some instances, stubbornness. And oftentimes you need to be aggressive and you need to let folks know that you're there on behalf of the people that you represent. but also that you want to play a role in decisions that are being made that affect the entire Commonwealth of Massachusetts. And when I started back in 1997, and here in 2014, we've worked on a lot of issues that affect not only Charlestown and Chelsea and the city of Boston, but the entire Commonwealth of Massachusetts. And it is a privilege to serve in the House of Representatives, and something that I will never, ever forget.
Let me tell the viewers out there, I forgot to mention at the beginning, that this is a live call-in show. And if you'd like to call in and speak with Jean, please do. The number is 617-708-3290. It's down at the bottom of the screen. Billy, do you want to?
Yeah, I was going to say, when we got the word, you know, we had an idea that Gene is a very loyal person, and the person that asked him is very close to him, so it's not surprising. But all the feedback that I've received is it was like, good move, very congratulations. I mean, everybody is very up for this. I mean, they're looking forward to your new job. I mean,
but they're missing you. They don't want you to leave your old job, though. So if you could do both at the same time.
Well, I know that nobody, including myself, likes change. Mm-hmm. When all of us become accustomed to something, it's very difficult for us to think of the future, and it's just a part of human nature, I think, to just in general oftentimes be a little anxious and to be a little uncomfortable about new things. But look, there was somebody in the seat before me, there will be somebody in the seat after me.
Right.
And whoever that person is will be given an incredible opportunity and responsibility to represent the people in the House.
We have a phone call, Jean.
We do, okay.
Hello, caller, come in.
Hi, everybody, how are you?
Hi, Jean. Jean Talkerman. Hi, Jean. Happy New Year.
And the same to you all. My heart is broken on one hand, and I'm happy for Jean on the other. If I had thought about the outcome, I might have voted differently, Jean. But your friendship has been very precious to me, and I hope it will continue. And as replacing you, it's the same issue as replacing Judy Evers. These things are never going to happen. They may aspire to climb to the heights you guys have set, but they're not going to get that far. I doubt it, seriously. So keep in touch, and God bless you, and love you, and all of you. Good night.
Nice. Good night, Jean.
Yeah,
good
thanks, Jean. I appreciate that. And look, for the folks in Charlestown, you should know that Mayor Walsh has, in his administration, a requirement under the law that taking this new position, I have to move into the city of Boston. So you'll be gaining me as a neighbor. I will see you walking up Main Street or Bunker Hill Street or whatever street I end up on. And after a while, you might get sick of me. But
that will never happen. So, okay, that was one of my questions. So you are going to move into Charlestown.
Part of the requirement to work for the mayor is a residency requirement. And certainly being part of the mayor's administration, I will have to be a resident. You know, I was asked a question by a reporter, you know, it's going to be difficult for you moving into the city. And I said, look, when I was in high school, I went to Marlin Catholic. A lot of the kids I hung around with were from Charlestown. You know, I grew up with kids that lived on Baldwin Street. I grew up with kids that lived in Mishawam and Newtown. I'm very familiar with Charlestown. Mm-hmm. I've had the privilege of representing the neighborhood for the last 18 years now that we're in 2014. In the House, I am familiar with its streets. I'm familiar with its people. I'm familiar with its organizations. Mm-hmm. When Patricia and I talked about the responsibilities that are involved with accepting this job, and certainly that was one of the things we discussed, I think we both instantly agree that the neighborhood that we love the most in the city of Boston is the neighborhood of Charlestown, and we're looking forward to that new adventure.
So Boston gains twice here.
Well, this is that's what we were saying.
Yeah.
You know, we were talking, we say we're not really losing nothing, we're gaining.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a big shot in the arm for us too. I was fortunate to call Gene the other day. It was funny. And I think he was in session, but he said, I'm very busy. But he took the time to talk to me. I just wanted to congratulate him. So I called him on his phone, and he answered. And then he said, oh, yeah, by the way, I'm going to be your neighbor. I said, I hope you're not a noisy neighbor. So it was good.
We are.
We made a joke out of it, so it was good.
And I know that that Gene is only joking about not voting for my dear friend.
Of course, we couldn't have a better mayor.
But it was, look, Marty and I started the same year in the Massachusetts House together. He is a person that that I have grown to know closely. And I think the city of Boston is in great hands. Mm-hmm. He's a person that takes his job very seriously, but doesn't present himself as somebody to be serious around. He's a, a great human being. He's a great character, and he's somebody that has done some outstanding work in the legislature. He is ready for this job day one. What's interesting about the background that he has picked up in the legislature is, in order for us to do anything in the legislature, we have to work with our colleagues. And what's interesting now about the position that Marty is in is, as the chief executive officer of the city, you know, he gets to make decisions without things having to go to committee or, but his nature after the years he has spent in the legislature will mean that the residents in Boston that participate in government will find that they have a mayor that wants to work and wants to collaborate with them. And that's what is exciting about this new opportunity for me. Personally, you want to think that you can always stay in politics, and perhaps you can continue to win elections. But each person that serves in public life will someday be presented with a choice. That choice hopefully is a choice they make themselves and not to be voted out by the people or whatever may happen. And so when a person makes a choice to leave public life, more often than not, folks go into the private sector. But it's exciting to be given an opportunity to stay in public service. Corporation Council, which is the role that I will be assuming on behalf of Mayor Walsh, in essence is the chief legal counsel for the mayor and for the city council and for the departments that serve as the city government, the operations, the nuts and bolts of city government. All of that requires in each of its departments its own machinery to operate, but at the end of the day, anything involving the legalities of how city government functions or any of the decisions that the mayor may make has to be reviewed by its law department. And I've been a lawyer for 20 years. It is a profession that when I first entered it was as honored entering that profession as I was when I was first elected to the House. Practicing law in Massachusetts, which has a judiciary that is nationwide recognized, has been a great privilege and something I'm looking forward to. I think we have another
phone call. We have another phone call, Gene. Hello, caller.
Hi there, how are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm good, Cookie. Hi, Gene and Billy, how you doing?
Good, very good.
Hi.
Good. Gene, I just want to congratulate you. It's been a great run with you and certainly going to miss you, but I hear you're going to be our neighbor, so you'll be working with a great team, you and Marty, and I'm sure you'll be good to us here in Charlestown as you have been in the past. So good luck, and wanted to wish you well.
Is this Ann?
Yes, it is.
Hi, Ann. I recognized your voice.
We couldn't pick it up. We were trying to pick it up.
Oh, I'm sorry. I guess I should have said Ian McCarron. I just thought they had told
18
you.
18 years in office, you can't prank phone call me. I'll pick up all of your voices.
Well, you never know what I'm going to be up to, Gene. So.
Thank you, Ann. I appreciate your sentiments. Thank you.
All right.
Happy New Year, Ian. Thank you for calling.
I knew the voice was familiar.
Yeah,
it just
too.
Took me a couple of seconds to figure that out.
That's what we were looking at. I'm going, I don't know.
So let me ask you this, Gene.
Yes.
When do you officially leave the State House?
So I will be resigning my seat on Friday, January 31st, and I have already furnished a letter that was drafted by Alexis, my chief of staff. I couldn't write it myself. We on January 31st, will be leaving our position as representative for the 2nd Suffolk. Secretary Galvin, I believe, is in the process, if he hasn't done it officially yet, I think he has, of setting what will be the special election to fill my seat. And I will begin my new job working for Mayor Walsh on Monday, February 3rd. So no time for vacation except a couple of days.
No, wow. So people have asked me, what will happen if people want services from our state representative? What will happen as of the 31st?
Sure. So anyone after the 31st that needs our office in the usual custom that folks contact our office, whatever they may require, that number that they're used to, 722-2396, is the number that they can continue to call. Speaker DeLeo will make sure that any constituent requests that are sent from my district are dealt with by either a staff member that will be assigned in the interim period. In other words, nothing to worry about for folks back home in terms of constituent services. Senator DiDomenico was also kind enough to reach out and to say that his Senate office and his staff that also deal with constituent services, he also represents obviously Charlestown and Chelsea, will also be available to handle any state requests that may come in. And also we have a great relationship with our other partners in government, both on the city level and on the federal level, and know that the vacuum will be filled quickly with any individuals that are looking for any help or support from the government.
Well, it'll never be the same, but it's good if someone has an emergency situation that they have just relied upon you so much for.
Absolutely, and I do appreciate, you know, stating that things will never be the same, and it's nice. It's nice to hear that. I want you to know that it's very humbling, and I appreciate that. But I want folks to know that that anyone that thinks that they're irreplaceable, there's a problem with that person.
I hear you. Yes.
So
yes.
Somebody will take my seat. Somebody will perform the duties of this seat. Somebody will discharge the duties of this seat. And the beauty of our government, as a matter of fact, the beauty of the Massachusetts legislature, is that it is a symbol not only in the United States, but our great and general court is the longest serving legislative branch in the Western Hemisphere. Institutionally, it is designed to take folks that are given the privilege to run and to be elected to serve, it gives them the tools that they need to learn quickly how to service their constituents. And I think that there is, when I first got into the legislature, when I first became a lawyer, I didn't know where to stand in court, but somebody showed me. And when I first got elected to the legislature, I was given incredible advice by members that I served with on how to become a representative, what to do, the things that are important, the things to avoid. And whoever becomes the representative from this district will also be given that opportunity. And so I think folks should be encouraged that we have a great system of government with all its faults, with all of the criticisms that are associated with it. I've been exposed to it for a lot of years now, and I am overwhelmed at times by the character and the work ethic of people that devote their life to public service. Too often in the age that we're in, you only hear when things
go bad.
But being exposed to it for as long as I am very comfortable going on and pursuing something else in my life, knowing that there is an institution in place that is built and is premised on the idea of service and continuity, and I think that that will occur in this case too.
I was going to ask you, Eugene, that I'm very curious. I've been over City Hall a million times. Where were you, your office? I mean, you have 60 lawyers underneath you, and so are you going to be up on the fifth floor with the rest of the guys, or do they get you downstairs? Or?
Well, I know that Mayor Walsh is on the fifth floor, and I expect to be on the fifth floor quite a bit, regardless of physically where my office is located. But currently the law department is on the sixth floor.
Okay.
And you are correct, Billy. It is one of the largest law departments in the city of Boston in terms of the number of lawyers. Yeah. There's probably a little over 60 folks that work there. Maybe 35 to 40 lawyers, the rest are paralegals and support staff.
Oh, wow.
They have a number of different divisions that deal with a whole host of issues that the city faces in terms of legal issues. They have a division that is devoted exclusively to government services. They have a division that deals with tax issues, a division that deals with school department issues, Boston police issues. And obviously the advice that you have to give to the mayor and to the city council as well. So there's a lot of different divisions within the law department. each including the litigation division and the claims division, which have almost 2,000 claims each year brought against the city of Boston for a whole host of different reasons. So a litigious environment and an environment in which there's a lot of work to be done each and every day.
So you handle the lawsuits. If a firefighter decides he's going to sue the city because he, say, hypothetically, he got laid off or fired, that's your office job?
All of those instances involving any suits brought against the city will go through the law department. And also any issues involving any of those departments that require under the jurisdiction for matters to be referred to the law department, we'll deal with. So it's, look, it's a big job. I'm excited about it. I think being chair of Judiciary for 12 years has prepared me for this job. We handle in the Judiciary Committee the largest amount of bills in the Massachusetts legislature. We're used to a busy work environment. We're used to being presented with complex and sensitive issues and trying to figure out a way to get to a solution. The difference for me this time will be, in the past I always served my speaker and I served as a member of the leadership team. And I think for me, in my mind, how I envision my new role, it's you know, it's not going to be the speaker, but it's going to be the mayor of the city of Boston. And I will be there to offer what I can in terms of my experience and my counsel for decisions that he's going to need help in.
I was very, I heard today that they appointed Christopher Arena back as the Veterans Affairs Commissioner.
Oh, yes, Francisco.
Francisco,
yes,
yeah,
absolutely.
I was
no stranger to Charlestown.
Yeah, somebody that. And you know, he's such an asset to the veterans of the city of Boston.
You know, what I appreciate Billy about him is I remember the American Legion Post 26, the Jim Conway post. Every year you do your annual installation of officers, and it was great seeing him at the recent one.
Yeah, that's why I said 2 minutes.
No, he's telling us we got two more minutes.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah. So we're gonna give you those 2 minutes, Gene. What would you like to talk about? Is there anything? I don't want to put you on the spot.
Well, I started at the outset, I think, by talking about the privilege that I have been given. And I want you to know that, you know, when I was 26 years of age and I pulled papers to run for this seat, I remember knocking on doors in Charlestown. And I remember saying, look, you know, just give me a chance. You gave it to me. So thank you.
We have never regretted it, Gene. We've never regretted it. And, you know, now we're going to be your neighbor. And I would hope that everyone would have it in their mind that as of midnight, January 31st, don't call him if you need something. He's starting a new career. He's going to have a life. Not that I think you're going to have less hours with this new position. It's really a fantastic position that you're taking on. So I'm not going to say that we're going to miss you because we're still going to have you, but just in a different way. So we're just thrilled. So we still have a minute. Billy, do you want to say anything to
him? No, I was glad because I've worked with Gene over probably 15 of the 17 years, and I've had the privilege through the veterans, through Chad, through hockey. I mean, the man has been involved in everything. He was an asset to the town, so
certainly
I hope whoever
been.
Takes over remembers that. All right, now with that...
Well, let me ask one really quick question.
Yes.
When will the race be? When will they have an election, like April 1st, or is there a date set for that
I would
yet?
Say that next week's paper, as well as Charlestown Live, you'll have the information and you'll be able to announce that.
Good.
All right, we just got the wrap-up, so I think with that, I want to thank our special guest tonight. It was a great show. I'm glad he came on. It will eliminate a lot of phone calls and innuendos and rumors, but I want to thank Representative Gene O'Flaherty for coming on with us tonight. And again, I want to thank our partner, Chad, and our sponsors, the Partners Healthcare, the Mass General Shop Program, and remember, Charlestown, respect one another. Good night. God bless Charlestown.
And one more note, we have a new opening and closing, so pay attention. Charlestown's favorite song is going to be played right now. Thank you, folks. Good night.
And remember Charlestown, now and forever. God bless Charlestown. Good night.